You won't believe where we're at today, the world famous Apache Leap. If you would have been at this location 150 years ago, what you would have witnessed would have been absolutely unbelievable. This is the legend known as the Apache Tears. So what happened that fateful day when 25 Apache warriors took their lives by jumping off the Apache Leap? Legend says that they were out raiding. And they camped the night on this cliff thinking that, you know what, if you're this high up, guess what? You know, nobody's going to be able to sneak up on you. And what happened was the opposite. They did sneak up on them. And immediately 50 of the warriors were killed. And the other 25 warriors went to the edge of the cliff with nowhere else to go. And they had two choices that day. Turn around and let the white man kill them, or jump to their death with dignity. So guess what? They stood at the edge of that cliff and they made that decision that day that they were going to jump to their deaths, and they did. 25 Apache warriors jumped off that cliff that day. So on that fateful day, when those Apaches jumped to their death, their loved ones went to the bottom of that cliff to collect their bodies. And the legend says that those tears that they wept that day turned to stone. And if you have one of those Apache tears, you don't have to cry anymore because they already have.
Jay and James, and we're gonna go find Apache Tears today.
You know, we've done the story about the Apache Tears, right? And how they became to be the Apache Tears, right?
That's right.
Now we're gonna go dig some Apache Tears up, right?
Yes, we are. And we've read about some cool places you can go find them pretty easily.
Man, I hope you're not. I hope you say, because what if we don't find any Apache Tears? I mean, I'm concerned about that.
Well, that's why I said I want to jinx us a little bit, because it shouldn't be too easy. That's no fun.
Well, I got hammers. You didn't bring a hammer.
I didn't. You got me a hammer.
I got an Apache Tear hammer.
You knew I was going to forget my hammer. So what is an Apache Tear?
An Apache Tear is a stone that was made by the gods. Of once those Apache women cried, their tears turned to stone. That's what I believe it is.
If you're of a scientific mindset, I believe it's black obsidian, correct?
Well, but I'm not talking about this. We're not talking about black obsidian. We're talking about the legend, James.
Okay, that is true. That is true. We are talking legends here.
I mean,
but if you're into the other geological side of it, I believe they're black obsidian.
We came up a back alley, which isn't what we saw, right, James?
No, this is different from what we were looking at.
You know, but the funny thing is, everywhere you look through these rocks, You know, you see Apache tears all through here. You know, I was curious to how many you would see. And, you know, the Boy Scout video I saw, everybody had a bag of them. And I didn't realize, you know, I thought, man, I hope they haven't got all of them. Well, come to find out, you know, we're in this beautiful valley. I mean, this is like Arizona highways all around. And this looks like tailings right here in front of us. Like this came out of that area above. So we know there's a big structure up there that's fenced off, but we can't find it. Now, up on that hill up there, you know, it looks like where I saw them looking for stuff, right? Looking for Apache stones up there, Apache tears up there. So let's take a run over this ridge right up here, James, and let's see if we can't find that structure. It's got to be here somewhere. There definitely seems to be some weird... Look at that big rock. Man, I gotta be careful with that one. I'm gonna be very gentle. There it was.
Ooh, that's pretty cool.
It's one of the biggest ones we found yet. Now look along here. They're all scattered everywhere. All through here. Big, little. Look at that vein of something right there. That's a nice one right there, James.
Yeah, man. These are cool.
Shit's everywhere. Look at that. Right there. So, we came out of that valley. I'm looking for this structure, and we came to the bottom side. Now this valley is unbelievable, and hell, there's a rim to a car right down there. Now this wall looks like tailings, and this wall was a son of a bitch. Right there, you know any other way to put it.
Walking through that wasn't fun.
So we're gonna kind of walk through this valley. Looks like a trail right there. Actually, I'm hoping that to be the truth. Tell you what, I'm not gonna, well, fuck, I never know. I was gonna say I wasn't gonna wear these fucking shoes. These fuckers are all over.
Fuck yeah, dude.
Another rim. Does this look like a trail to you?
This right here?
Yeah.
I mean, someone's gone through that. I mean, it's not like a trail, but it's definitely a path.
Look at this. Get the camera on.
It's on.
Look at these. They're everywhere. Look at that thing. Wow. It's just everywhere. Look at all. You know, look at the size of this one. It's as big as that one we knocked out of there. I hope everybody appreciates me and James hauling this shit back. This is a hell of a hill, though. We got to get up this and see what we've got. That hill crossing over there, that thing, if it was a ski run, it'd be black or double black. That's a double black hill right there. You're not walking up it. But we're going to try this. Here's a trail here. Somebody's walked through here.
Can we find a way out of here?
Man, we've been getting some ass busters here lately, haven't we?
Yeah, welcome to the world.
You know,
Black Flag Expeditions hiking.
Tell you what, that was a bitch coming out of that valley. We're not out of it yet, even though I think we're pretty close. What I'm guessing is when we go over this ridge, we're going to find that area that's fenced off. And these are all tailings.
Yep.
So, right. So we're going to find out in about 5 minutes.
Come along.
If that was true or not. Yeah. You know, I could have swore, James, in the video that I saw, that the trail went through here and around, and that there's a trail right there. Maybe that's it. That you didn't have to go around the other way, but maybe that's not true. What we can do is, and that's a pretty cool structure. I mean, all this stuff came down that hill, and all those tailings got pushed down that hill. And it's a pretty cool place. It really is. Now, I've seen people chipping on this, all this wall up here. I've seen them chipping over there on that one, across over there. And we've already found at the bottom of this hill, we've already found them. We also found a new species of rock. You know that, James? Did you know that? You know, here it is right here. This is called the German tear. Because it's kicked my German ass. I'm telling you that right now, okay?
Because you're shedding some German tears.
I'm shedding some German tears.
Well, the rocks made you work for it today.
So I am going to go around and take a look. Oh, look, the fence is down. No wonder.
Yeah, that's...
So, man, they're everywhere. The valley was beautiful. I just wish I'd have known, you know, maybe a different time of the year, it'd have been a lot better or easier to hike. But we're going to go over here and take a look, because it says stay clear, we shouldn't. This thing has just been beat to death, but you still see more in there. Looks like a javelina jaw.
Javelina's jaw.
I saw javelina droppings over there. I definitely wouldn't be chipping away on the supports. That's for sure. But I would like to see what they were looking for. Who would have spent that much time doing that? Now that looks like lantern, because this isn't ancient by no means that I'm aware of.
No.
How the hell would they have got up there? Those are excellent drawings, though. Holy shit, look at them.
Yeah, they look legit. I don't know, man.
So, now those don't. Well, this will be good to do a research on.
Yeah, that tends to be an important part of what we do, actually looking this stuff up. Oh, wow. You got a rope.
Smoke dope. Peary blood up. That was an interesting climb. Not impossible, but interesting.
Might not be the smartest thing to hook yourself to a random piece of metal.
Here's modern. Does feel good back here though, James. I'd be lying to say that I don't trust it. I don't trust this place.
I should camp here overnight. This is definitely a widowmaker.
But it is an incredible structure. Trail right here.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what. Look, there's Weaver's Needle.
Yeah.
Look at that. What a beautiful shot that is. You know, man, you can see that everywhere. Now there's also Picket Post. Look at that valley in there. Isn't that beautiful? So we came along the bottom trail. Now, one thing I can tell you is this. If you want to find Apache tears down there, they're laying in that creek bed on the very bottom. If you want to take a walk down there with no hammering or anything, right? I mean, they're everywhere. Up here, they were fairly picked clean. And that's okay. I think I've had enough of Apache tears. I know why they call them Apache tears is because I was crying on that. I was whining like a little bitch, James.
You were a little frustrated.
You know,
I was a little frustrated. You know, I think that might be part of the Arizona Trail down there. That gate you see? I'm gonna guess, I'm pretty familiar with those. So I think what we were on was part of the Arizona Trail or something. I'm not 100%.
Look at that valley down there, isn't that beautiful? Oh, it goes around. Remember, we went through the trail over there. You don't have to go over. You go through this valley and through here.
Yeah.
Exactly. You get to mark off some Arizona Trail, James.
Bushwhacking.
Holy hell.
But, you know, that's how we like to do things. We do it the hard way, so maybe you don't have to later on when you come out and try to see what we've done. All right. Well, we're going to keep moving down the trail and give you guys a little taste of what we missed.
You know, we learned about all the different things, and now we learned about the Apache Trail, We learned about the Apache Leap today, and we learned about the Apache Tears.
Yep.
We definitely found some Apache Tears, we're going to give them some of them away, aren't we? Take the bottom trail. We wouldn't have planned that, but exactly, right, James? If you take that trail that loops and goes down, it'll take you over into this valley, and what you get is all the tailings from this mine right here. Now, it's a pain in the ass to try to get up that hill, but if you're in that valley, they were all over in them rocks and those tailings down there. We saw them everywhere, didn't we? I mean, it was like incredible.
Literally, so just walking on a trail full of them.
Yeah, so you know, you come up here and people have kind of picked the ones off the floor. Even though they're still here, but the good ones, you know, are down there, and a lot of times you don't even need to do anything. Yeah, I mean, you don't even got to do anything. You got to do no work. If you go to the bottom of the creek bed, remember, water pushes everything downhill. So where are you going to find all this stuff eventually? At the bottom of the canyon, right? Look at that picket post right there, James. Tell me that isn't, and that wall over there, tell me that isn't Arizona Highways material right there. This place is incredible. I can feel ancients back here, whether they were back here or not. You can feel it. You can feel the ancients back here. You really can. What a great place this was.
Well, it's just over there is the dwellings we found, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
So, yeah, they were all over these areas. What a cool deal. What a great day today. Glad everybody could come along with us, man. This was a lot of fun. I enjoyed it. I'll be honest. I was pissed off at the bottom of that hill. Because I saw the map. Well, there's the trail we're on right now. I mean, I saw it from the air, but we went too far down. But what we found out was that's the best place to be if you're looking for these. It's not up here. It's down in that valley, in that creek bed. You get in that creek bed where the trail starts to stop, and you start following that creek bed, and they're all over down there, and there's good ones down there. Up here, like I said, I don't know if any water's going to come off these anywhere either. So I like this one because it's like stuck in a rock. That's one of the sins of rocks. Okay, that's a few. I got more. Now, what's great about this is we're going to give these away. Okay, so if you subscribe, you're going to get an Apache Tear. It's blocking your... there we go. So you're going to get one of these Apache Tears. Okay, if you subscribe, that's all you got to do. Going to put it in an envelope. It ain't going to be too ceremonial. Just going to give me your address. I'll throw it in an envelope and we'll go. That probably won't go in an envelope, but these will, right? Some of these will. So, yeah, what a great day it was, man. Apache Tears. Hey, and the creek's running. How crazy is that? This is awesome. So, what a great day at the pier, James.
Not bad.
Let's take this stuff home. Water's awesome.